Hello friends and viewers, I'm Krupali Patel. I'm studying in Federation University as per requirement of my subject, which is iTech 2307. I'm making this video. In this video, I'm going to tell about the four topics, which include telecommuting, problem management, future management, challenges, and technology overviews. First, I would like to tell about telecommuting. What is telecommuting? The basic simple definition is people can work from home or take advantage of internet. In this, the employee can work outside of the office, no need to go to office. In this, I can say that working from home or maybe different location, it can happen sometime. I would say anyone can who live in Melbourne or any other city in Australia, he or she can work from Sydney branch or any other branch in all over the Australia. In addition, for telecommuting is the internet, fax, phones, webcams or messaging format are used to telecommuting for the communication. In this age of technology, it is common to use it. Now, talking about the advantages and disadvantages of telecommuting. Talking about advantages first, there are many advantages of telecommuting. It is a great opportunity for single parents as well as for those who are physically not fit, like physically disabled, for those people. Secondly, I would say you don't need to tackle with the traffic and all that stuff. Like instead of sitting in a traffic, people can spend that time on a different way, like whenever they want to do, like go to workout and go for the gym and for the beach and for relax and anything. Otherwise, and other thing I would say, it can cut the cost of the traveling as well. Like you don't need to go to office day by day regularly, so it cut the cost of the petrol and anything. In a reverse manner, it has some disadvantages as well. If you are working at home, you might not concentrate as they need, the actual work need to concentrate, just because there are many can easily distract you, like, such as crying children if you have a children, barking at dogs if you have dogs, and family member or visitors can easily distract you. You can become easily distracted if you are not so responsible person, because no one can supervise you, no one can see you, that like you can watch TV and anything if you are at home, staying home and working it. And the next, I would like to talk about my next topic, which is problem management. Problem management, like what is problem management? According to my research, I can say it is the process of responsible for the managerial, the life cycle of all problems. It can work with accident management as well as change management. Like they can work together, the accident management and the change management work together and become the problem management. Just for the ensuring like IT service, the technical support is available for any time, like 24 hours as well. They maintain the quality of the service, like highest the quality rate and like this. In this situation, when any accident or problem happens, over time speed up to solve that problem. When accident happens, this management will come and solve this. This is the simplest definition of problem management, according to my knowledge as well as my research. I would like to tell about the roles as well as the responsibility of the problem management manager. First, he or she needs to define the main thing, like what is the problem and what is the procedure they're going to follow. Periodically, review of the problem management process. They need to coordinate between different teams as well as different system, as well as different people, different culture as well. He or she needs to identify the cause of the problem and get the solution of it. The most important things is in here is it is ensured that the resources are available to investigate the main problem is like what is the main problem. It is in charge for the resolution also implements via the suitable control process. Problem management includes the main activity of the root cause of the accident as well as determine the solution to existing problem. Now guys, moving on to my third topic is future management challenges. Like we know that the world is going very fast, so what is the future for the manager challenges? The simplest way to explain of future management challenges is what could be the problem for the challenge for the future manager to manage things nicely. What will the problem and how to solve it? I would say there are going to be tough for the future management roles. For example, like in calls nowadays, we can see like in a grocery store or in Woolworth, we can see like they are using the self-checkout system. In this, we can see that an Apple or any other things, like we can choose the look of the item and just select the items. Like for this, we can select the cheapest price even though they are not on the cheapest price. Just need to choose a different category of a product and no one can see that code because the barcode is not given to each Apple. That is the main reason I would say. In this situation, how to overcome with this problem, particular challenges? Likewise, there will be more and more challenges will arise. Therefore, need to more care towards managerial role, need to take appropriate decision. After our research, I come up with three main parts of this, like how can the future management going to be tough. First, I would say flexible work arrangement. In this, the coming generation want to anything has to be flexible, relaxable, as well as the setups. And the major concern must be kept on giving results. Secondly, I can see the like clear, transparent work culture and open leadership. Like we can see nowadays, no one wants to work in a culture whenever they are. Make a difference between culture and like skin complexion, I would say. This means these days need to clear the culture barrier and the skin complexion differences. At last but not least, I would say, is keeping stakeholder happy. In this, I would ask like, who are the stakeholders? Anyone can who is directly or indirectly affected by company is a stakeholder actually. This will be a main challenges according to my research, like how to make happy the stakeholders. This will be the challenges for according to my research and view. Now at last, the fourth topic is and the last topic is technology overuse. So my next topic is technology overuse, as we can't deny like that is the use of technology changes our lifestyle in many ways, as it's playing a positive important role in our life. But if we consider the other side in a long run, it has some negative effect on individual. Like it's going to be bad effect for the people if they are overusing. Being addicted to technology and devices may develop unhealthy lifestyle and can lead to the poor time management. Due to the technology overuse, there could some management health issues as technology is growing day by day. So I'm going to discuss about the negative impact that can cause by technology overuse. First, it affects the academic performance of the students if they are addicted to some sort of the activity of technology, that can be video games, like YouTube channels, watching TV, playing game, anything. Religion, the second thing is relationship could be affected as technology overuse impacts on health can social behavior of person can affect the overall development of the individual compared to the youth. So I can say like steps can be done to overcome these issues. Like for the in a survey or studying should be done in a way to analyze the reason of overuse technology that could be done. Like first, examine the time spent by youth with their tech device. Second, examine the intention behind use of the tech, like how going, why they are using this tech technology frequently. Study the impacts of the addictive use of tech gadgets and service on mental health lifestyle. Moving further, I would like to talk about how can manage this overuse. Relationship between technology and overall development should be understood. Parents should facilitate a balanced and healthy environment to their children regarding the technology use. Academics and health professionals should conduct some part of surveys in this field. Like they have to be careful about how they are using, why they are using, what they are using. Thank you so much for listening to me. See you.